It's all about that intellectual honesty. Gotta be honest with yourself. Alright, well, I'm here, and the woman's continuing to talk. And even more annoying than hearing her voice going, "Warning, warning, without authorization," is the fear of, like, screwing up the recording again. I hope the precautions I've taken against that will keep this from being a problem. So this is a space station. I have to, I'm sorry. Ah. I'm not going to be able to shine spark up through that, am I? Because those blocks will stop me, probably. Let's try it. I should have just enough room. I'm going to try this without actually, you know, properly progressing just yet. Run, 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 run. And crouch. And shine spark up. And poop. Yep, thought so. I don't know what's going to clear that barrier out of the way, but meh. Oh, shit. This is not the best thing that's happened today. This, you know, I fear, I don't know if it's technically possible given the lore of the game. I fear X amalgamates of Metroids. But I don't know if that's even doable because the Metroids would feed on the X. Oh my. Scary shit. Oh god! This is the first time I've seen this since Metroid 2. Alpha Metroid, Gamma Metroid. Actually, oh no, that's an infant Metroid. This is an Alpha Metroid. This is a Gamma Metroid. That's a Zeta Metroid. And that leads me to know really, really well what's going to be in the next room. Oh shit, oh shit, oh shit. There's an Omega Metroid around here somewhere. I really don't want to fight that thing. Oh, yep, there it is. Where are you, dude? Come on. I know you want to come out here. Where are you? Okay, there's like a little aperture in the wall over here. Am I supposed to do something with that? Nope. Let's try charging. Okay, nothing's happening in this room, so I guess I'll go back and have a boss fight with a freaking Omega Metroid. Oh god, I don't want to face one of those things. Oh god, this is even worse. The sacks! Uh-oh. Oh, wow. Okay. The Metroids are destroying the sacks. My soul-saving grace. I wonder if they'll avoid me because I'm now one of them? Oh, shit. Come on, space jump properly. They're not actively attacking me, but they'll still hurt me if they hit me. I wonder if I've already lost. I don't know how much time this really means. Holy crap. Wait, is that the way the sax dies? I'm not the one who gets to kill it? Ah ha ha, frustration. I wanted to fight that thing. Damn it. Alright, what do you got for me, Adam? Samus, you shouldn't have done that. You ignored your orders. I don't even... You may have to pay a price for that quite soon. Oh, Samus actually going to speak? As you can see, the Federation has been secretly working on a Metroid breeding program. Oh, boy. For peaceful applicant... Sure. I accept that at face value. But perhaps you already knew this program's existence. Certainly, you must have had doubts when you saw Sector 1. SRX, a faithful replica of SR388 ecosystem. Yes. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Ideal for raising Alpha, Gamma, Zeta, and even Omega Metroids. This research even uncovered techniques for rapid growth. Imagine creating an Omega Metroid larva for... Why would you want to do that? Those things were super weapons. I don't want to face those guys again. But this research is finished. The X has smelled out its natural enemy, and one of the sacks is on its way... What? Were there multiple sacks? Or did I misread that? One? Are you... Oh, yep. Yeah, so finally Samus is speaking, just like Master Chief. Don't be so surprised, Samus. You know, I was wondering about this. If the Sax was so powerful of an ally for the X, then why not just make more and make a ton of it and have an endless bred army of super weapon Samuses? Because of this mechanism, there are now no fewer... It just keeps getting better and better. I have to fight 10 fucking Saxes on the station. Yeah. Samus, you must go. Get out. If you stay too long, the sacks will destroy you. Stop only at a navigation uplink to me. I don't know what HQ is going to do for this, but you need to report to them immediately. Okay. I don't know why I should trust you at this point. But, okay, yeah, so this is uncertainly going to be a running mission where I'm going to encounter a whole bunch of sacks that I have to run away from. Jesus. The real Adam would have said the same thing about that incident, but he would have softened the blow. He was relentless in his criticism, but he always cared. He was not a machine obsessed with duty. No such compassion could exist in that computer. Other M really ruined your canon, you know that? That Adam was not compassionate. He fucking shot you in the back. And then apologized for being so hard on you. Idiots. Sorry. I said I would stop talking about Other M, and I'm still doing it. This is all new to me. I don't have a screw attack yet, so this is gonna hurt. Yep. Wait a second. This looks kind of familiar. I wonder if my brain is going into, like, a memory-based confirmation bias here. Yeah, this indeed looks familiar. This looks like a portion of the Turian escape sequence in Super Metroid. You know, when you'd have the hyper beam and you'd be hyper beaming and speed boosting through all those near invincible space pirates. Does that work? Let's try it. Full charge. It does work. Sweet. These fusion missiles or diffusion missiles, I should say, are pretty dang cool. I know I've missed a couple of energy tanks previously. Ow. I'd be lying if I said I wasn't really worried about these environs. And I wonder if they were deliberately designed to look like the Turian escape sequence. I don't know. Ah, acid. What the hell are you? What the hell are you? Get away from me. Okay, well, obviously your sacks amalgamates, but I don't know of what. You just feel lucky I got the plasma beam, so I take you out quickly, and it's not very painful. Oh, yep, okay, this is indeed acid. I'm probably protected from lava, but not from this. Such was the way of the gravity suit. Such was the way of the film Das Boot. I don't know which way to go. It's a crapshoot. Oh, save room. That's always good, right? Being able to record your progress. The friendly animal villagers in Animal Crossing told me it's important to do that. And obviously, when an anthropomorphic anime animal tells me to do a thing, I have to do what it says. At least that's what the voices say. And kaboom. Please? Yar. I am so sick of your guys' shit. In fact, you look like an old geriatric space pirate. Oh, you dudes again. You gonna vomit upwards this time? Are you gonna vomit upwards of this time? No. I have to kill you to do this, don't I? So it's either powerbomb you to death or... Oh, you! Yeah, you were one of the superpower space pirates. I have to wait until you do a thing that makes you vulnerable. Huh. Let's kill these other dudes just to get them out of the way. Wow, God, oh fuck, you're hurting me so much. Let's see, so charges aren't hurting you. I mean, your sprite color's not changing any point. Let's try a diffuser missile. Let's try actually charging properly. Let's try not letting up on my R button when I mean to fire. Nothing. Wow, nothing hurts you assholes. Okay, power bombs. Wow, I'm gonna die to these entirely mundane enemies. I mean, obviously they're not mundane. Should I just not have killed the dudes below me? Obviously that's the case, because now I'm gonna die because of this. Alright, let's just get it over with. Fuck shits and saucy bits. Yeah. Death. Now, let's try not to kill these dudes. I have to do that to open up, but yeah, this door's locked. So there's gotta be a way to kill the yellow space pirates. This door that was over here is not accessible, I'm pretty sure. Like, yeah, that guy looked like he had gray hairs. looked like an old space pirate. I've been trying to kill Samus since the grain shortage of 1322. Aha! So there's a way forward without fighting those yellow pirates. Maybe I need a hyper beam, and that's just all that's gonna happen in this worldly place. Very existential. Ha, you can't stop me no more. I live on double negatives. Maybe the yellow guys can be harmed with a screw attack. But I have yet to see one of those. Man, I've seen so many blocks that can be destroyed by screw attacks all over the goddamn place. Okay, so... Not really seeing another way to go. Which means... I've got to be able to fight those yellow dudes, don't I? Oh, that was random. I've seen so many things revealed recently that I only get just by powerbombing every map tile. And that's not great. I know it's a Metroid game, but this game has most decidedly set its pacing and tone and all of that to not be around free open world and exploration. Maybe I'm being too hard on it, though, because even though there is a difference between open world exploration and the more linear railroading that this game is doing, it's not like you're not required to explore just in each individual area. You indeed are. You're forced to. This game is basically forcing you to, or you can't advance. Now, I probably can't get up through here until I kill the yellow space pirates up above, either. I don't know how to deal with them, though. Let's save just again, so I don't think I've actually gotten anything since I last saved, but what the hell. At this point, you know, saves aren't going to hurt me. I'm already going to have, like, a 6-hour play time and a 20% item completion, and if those metrics are even tracked in a Metroid game like this that has a different flow. Well, I'll go up there and I'll probably just continue fiddling with the yellow dudes until I find a way forward. That did hurt you. Something I did hurt you. And I think it was right after you jumped, but your sprite didn't change color. So could I, like, hurt you right after you come down from a jump? That's arbitrary. And again, you're not seeing a sprite color change, so... Or can I just shoot you in the back? Maybe that's it. I can shoot you in the back, regardless of which way you're jumping or whatever. Wow, I didn't get much energy back for all that. That was a ton of X that I did not get energy back for. Go ahead, reform. I'll fight this dude too. It'll probably kill me, but now I know how, at least. Or do I not need to? The X ran off. Oh, the door's open now, too, so hoop-de-doo. Gotta try to replenish myself. Up or down? I choose to go down on this level. You know. Bow-chicka-bow-wow. I don't want to have to shoot you guys if I can possibly help it. What's the point of even being in this room now? No? Wow, so much nonsense is going on. I don't even get it. Hi, guys. Do you care if I freeze your entire existence? Because I don't need to step on you, but I just need you to stay out of my way. I wonder if we can work that out. Oh, Christ, a boss! Okay, well, I guess I'm going to go back up to that other door and see if I need a save or whatever. Just a save point, huh? I thought I'd have a resupply room. Even with the health refill that I usually get off of those boss doors, I've noticed that as my health bar gets bigger, the health refill has not been a necessary, just like complete full refill. It's just very large. So this is going to be a bit very difficult boss. Well, whatevers. I hope it's an Omega Metroid. I mean, as much as I was being all scared, I honestly would really like to see one of those in this game. That'd be frick-ass cool. Oh, hi. Do I have to fight an X-Amalgam Ridley instead? Yes? No? Maybe so? Oh, yep. You light up. Come on, Ridley. Do your thing. Oh, shit, fire! Yeah. Ex-Amalgam Ridley is scarier than usual. Please don't lift me up and take a million health away like you did in the other game. Holy shit, you're so much more terrifying than usual, even though you're probably not going to be any harder once I get a feel for how you work. Yeah, I'm already doing, like, significant amounts of damage to you. I can super missile the mother-loving shit out of you, too. I don't have to wait for a plasma beam charge up. Your tail is invincible. Give it up, Ridley! You will never be in Smash! Okay. Yeah, you're not as bad as the Zero Mission, Ridley. At least not, apparently, not yet. I can just pepper you with ordnance until you die miserably. Wow, you were screeching in pain, but your color's not changing as quickly as I'd actually like. Uh-oh. Okay, second form, or are you really dead? Okay. AIDS virus time, I guess. Oh, is this going to be the screw attack? I hope this is the screw attack. Come on, AIDS virus. I wish I could truly defeat you and be all the better for humanity. I wish I could create and market an AIDS virus where I would charge $1 per dose. I would still have enough money to live on for the rest of my life and still give a ton to charity. Ah! So this basically fully upgrades Samus. I don't think there's a single thing I'm missing at this point. Oh, yeah! And thankfully it isn't done, you know, at an irrelevant post-section of the game. Actually, no, I got the screw attack fairly early in Zero Mission, didn't I? Okay, well, I know where to go now. Oh, that's right, this doesn't even matter. I can just go through you dudes. Reckless impunity, that's how my life works. Reckless impunity, that's how I make you hurt. The space pirates are always a delight to kill when you finally get the screw attack. So, just as a side note, I know it's reiterating something I've said before, but this missile upgrade right here, this Diffuser Frost missile, this is the shit I'm talking about when it comes to getting all new, weird, different powers than what you've traditionally seen in Metroid games in the past. If every single one of my powers could be, like, as different on this scale from my previous examples of powers were, that would be fan-phenomenally-tastic. That would just be the best thing since the Immaculate Conception. There was a thing here, wasn't there? Or is that in the next room? Oh, yep, it's in the next room. I'm a giant tardhead. Forgive me my transgressions of tardheadedness. Why should I even charge when I can just somersault into you like a dickwad? Because that's what dickwads do. They somersault into people. You know how I know? Sonic the Hedgehog. Said Hedgehog. Hedgehog. Hugest dickwad in all of video gaming history. A 90s punk of the worst kind. And he somersaulted into people. Yes. This is a thing. It is canonical. You cannot deny it. Couple of seconds. This is appropriate, what we're seeing right here. Acid finally being colored green, so it's not as easy to confuse with just, you know, hotter lava. That's a good thing to see. Although I realize sometimes you have hardware limitations, that means you may not necessarily be able to set up the color space that you would have wanted. And this is back into familiar territory. Okay. So I will try to get back up to the nav room and see what Adam Sensei has to say. Actually, no, he's not my teacher, he's my commanding officer, so I suppose I'd call him Adam Kaicho. I haven't been able to get in over into this room, or at least large sections of it, and I should have abilities to let me do that now, right? Yeah, like the suit is totally impervious to lava. So there's gotta be some stuff down here I can do. Oh, yeah, hardly necessary. My missile stock feels kind of OP. The way I just completely demolished, sterated Ridley should show that. This looks like a Metroid egg. That's terrifying to me. That looks like a Metroid egg. save and deprave like a knave. Samus, we're done here. Leave the rest to the Federation. We should be preparing to evacuate the station. Are you joking? Do they know how dangerous the X are? How quickly do they reproduce? The Federation has taken interest in the X and the Sacks. They believe this life form has endless potential applications. This is ridiculous. The X are heartless abominations. I'm so morally outraged right now. Fuck you. What potential could they have? It's not necessary. They're going to use them as weapons, obviously, Samus. Come on. Federation is coming now. You should just leave quietly. This is... Yeah, I've never seen Samus speak this much before, and that it's happening so late in this game is, like, weird. It's off, kind of off-putting, honestly. But this is, like, dialogue straight out of the movie-slash-comic-book 300. This is madness! And then have the Adam AI kick her in the chest. This is... whatever the name of this space station is. The station will devour them. It's worth the risk. Capturing the Sacks, of course. Are you serious? Do they really think they can succeed? It will certainly be difficult, but they don't expect your help. They knew you would try to destroy the Sacks. That's why... why are you telling me all this? If you want me to leave, you should just shut off your information flow right now. You should stop informing me. Otherwise, I'm going to break orders and stay here. You know that. Why are you telling me this? No, that's just sending you support data. The plasma beam modification was ready some time ago, but the withheld to keep you from engaging the Sacks. Ha! Huh? Yet somehow you restored that function on your own. They also tried to withhold the diffusion missile upgrade because they didn't want you to grow too powerful. But they had already sent it, and you tracked it down. Bravo, Samus. Bravo. They must cancel this mission! Open a channel to HQ! I won't let this happen! They're already on their way. Fools. Fools, all of them. As soon as the Federation ships land, the X will overwhelm them and absorb the knowledge and power of their occupants. The X are just waiting for the hunt to begin, and then they'll spread out across the universe. Galactic civilization will end. The X hunger for form, knowledge, and power. They mimic these perfectly, but they cannot copy the soul. They're single-minded, instinctively seeking to increase in number. They're a plague, and the Federation underestimates their threat. The X must not leave here. I must destroy them all before the Federation arrives. This station is a self-destruct mechanism. Yeah. Something you should have done a long time ago, Samus. I must use it to destroy the X here and on the planet. I must send them to Oblivion, them, the station, and myself if I have to. All right. Well, you don't really have any interpersonal attachments, Samus, so that's fine. It looks like Adam's not opening the door for me. And I'm not seeing a way out. Open the damn door, you motherfucker! Open the hatch. I've been ordered to confine you until the ships arrive. Don't let them do this. Can't you see what will happen, Adam? Adam? You gave me a name? Who was Adam? A friend of mine. What would this friend advise you to do right now? He would know that the only way to end this is to start the self-destruct cycle. He'd know how important it is. Did this Adam care for you? Would he sit in a safe command room and order you to die? You know, unfortunately, the commanding officers or soldiers are indeed required to do that at times. It's not very nice. He would understand that some must live and some must die. He knew what it meant. He made that sacrifice once. Boy, other M raped that so bad. God, they raped it so bad. So he chose life for you, our fair warrior, Samus Aran, your Adam. So you might keep yours, hoop-a-doo, for the sake of the universe, blah. How foolish. How dare you? How could you hope to understand that, machine? You know that detonating the station in a high orb would not guarantee the complete extension of the X-Parasites. Even though the station would be utterly destroyed, you would only succeed in removing one obstacle to the galaxy's room yourself. You would ignore this simple fact and choose death. When Adam decided who would live, he chose incorrectly. Ouch! Damn! That stings, you fucking computer core. If you were to alter the station's orbit, you might be able to include the planet in the vaporization field of the self-destruct detonation. Really? That's gotta be one hell of a blast to take out a whole frickin' planet with it. Unless you have something like Orson Scott Card's idea of the molecular disruptor, the little doctor, starting a chain mechanism that would, you know, if the physical matter was in vicinity, it would just destroy any matter that was touching it. Let's see, you would have to start the propulsion sequence now before the Federation arrives. Samus, this is your last mission. Go to the operations room and adjust the station's orbit path. Oh, so we're over SR388. Okay. Then return to your ship and escape. Move quickly and stay alive. That's an order! Any objections, lady? How the hell do you know to say that? What kind of humanism have I, or human identity have I imbued you with just by using a name on you? There's no way you should know this. Any objections, lady? Huh. I wonder if what I thought originally was true then, that this is some kind of, like, neuron 2 transistor imprint of Adam's consciousness. And how would Biologic know to, like, pair that with Samus? Oh god, this is raising so many questions. I hope they are answered, but moreover, I just hope that I am not annoying. I know that I sometimes am, and it's not really fair. Target. Okay, off I go. How did we decide to kill these things? Oh, that's how, I guess. Okay. I thought power bombs was the official way. Speaking of which. Fawoomf, but not to very great effect. Huh. Wonder if I have to come down from above in a way that I've not yet seen. Whatevs, I've got plenty of power bombs. Oh, wrong way. Herpter. It would honestly be, like, too quick and too clean if this really was the end. I hope that I hate to say this, but I hope something goes wrong, because that Ridley being a final boss would be retarded in the extreme. Ooh, this room. This room. Is there going to be an Omega Metroid that I face in here? Aha. Yep, I knew it'd be too easy. What's here? Oh, a Sax! Fuck shits and saucy bits. Okay, so plasma certainly hurts you. Your screw attack hurts me like shit. I can freeze you. Touching you hurts the crap out of me. Look, I'm almost nearly dead. Yeah. Screw attacking you also hurts you, but you've got more health than I do, and you're hurting me way faster than I'm hurting you. Ow! You're more terrifying than an Omega Metroid. Damn it, and spam it, and cram it, and slam it! Attempt number two, probably the last on camera until victory. I wonder if I should just, like, adopt a strategy of freeze, shoot. Because I don't think the missiles directly hurt the Sacks. I have to use charged plasma boom shots. Yeah, like, regular plasma beam shots don't do anything. I can screw attack into it, but that's far too risky. How about fusion missiles? It takes, like, a long frickin' time to charge up. Oh, and I could just bounce off you anyway. Man! You still hurt me so much! Attempt number three. Ah, I'm just gonna keep screw attacking into me, huh? You run at my face rather than trying to shoot me from afar, because you know your screw attack does so much damage. So you can shoot me from afar, but you're choosing not to. So I'm gonna use range as my advantage here. Oh, Jesus! Oh, no. Don't do what you think. What I think you're gonna do. You have another form. Christ, this thing's gonna be hard to kill. Oh, and you don't care about level architecture. You'll just jump right through that shit. Okay. Ow, ow, ow. Nope, missiles don't hurt you. Gotta use charged plasma beam shots. Yep, you can just go right in front of... You can't... That's not a hiding spot where I can just shoot you. Okay. But you got a fairly regular jump pattern, it looks like. Okay, what's next? Is there anything next? Of course, the AIDS virus. Which I'm probably going to die to on my first attempt. Oh, is this Ice Beam? I probably won't be able to use this. I mean, I know I've got my Varia suit, but... I mean, if it's inside me, it probably is not going to be much help. Almost certainly I'm going to die to the AIDS virus here. God damn it. You're vulnerable quite conditionally. Takes a long time for your eyeball to open. And even then it's dangerous because that's when you shoot the beam. Get over here, Saxcore. Does that sound like a musical genre? Saxcore? Like some kind of a technocore thing of saxophone? Hey, get back here, you dickwad! I was gonna absorb you fair and square. Fuck shit's in every single saucy bit. Anyway, are any of these hatches open? No, not this one. I guess it doesn't matter if I'm gonna... This is almost certainly not the end. They're gonna do something to sabotage my attempt to do this. Oh my. Okay. I stand corrected. And I hope I don't die on my way out. Because I very well could. Well, at least the ship is close by. Come now. This is not the time to be lollygagging on elevator times. Uh-oh. Okay, well, that's not the best thing ever. Does this hatch open at least? Yes, it is. I need not to encounter a single X. It will murder me. Oh, okay. Maybe I can spare just a couple of seconds to regenerate myself. Hopefully I can. Quickly now. Thank you. Now if I run into any X, I can probably just tank past it. This is the way? Yes, yes. Okay. Please let me through. Oh, yep, just up through here. Okay. That X would be a really lackluster final boss as well. Only took me 3 attempts. Which I hope it's not. Also, there's not much happening to the station for a self-destruct sequence. Like, it's not blowing itself to pieces already, like, Zeb's and the Ceres station were. What? Oh, my ship's all the way down there! Fuck, I was going the wrong way! Oh, Christ, this isn't good. I've almost certainly run out of time. I was heading towards a boss icon and not towards my ship! Oh, God, you will have seen that immediately before, and I'm only just now noticing it, and I'm sure, like, several seconds ago, you were just yelling at your screen, you cunt, wanna do-do-do! And believe me, when I go back to review this footage for upload, I'm gonna be feeling the same way. Alright, I probably don't have enough time. I don't know, 90 seconds is gonna get me there, but nope, not saving over this stupidity. Hope that navigation flaw doesn't cost me my life. Docking base. Okay, I'm close. I'm very close. I might still just make it. Oh, God, this has been torn all to hell. I hope a Sax hasn't come through and tried to break my ship. Oh, no, 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 no. That's a giant Metroid egg. Where's my ship? panic. Oh, there it is. There's the Omega Metroid. I know I have to hit your gut. Oh, nothing's hurting you. I was able to hurt you with missiles before in Metroid 2. Oh my God. Okay, this is a supposed to lose fight. You just very nearly one-shotted me. You cut me down to 1 HP. Oh, that's the Sax virus, isn't it? What? What? What are you doing? What? Why would you protect me? Oh, the ice beam. Okay, now I can hurt your chest, but I'm out of time. And, this is over. I would have had to have gotten here a lot more quickly. Yeah, it's over. I lost. All the time I wasted going to the wrong room. Could I have beaten that? Well, obviously, yeah. Okay. So, let's try to do it right this time, because I have to take the battle with the Omega Metroid out of my time allotment. I'm gonna film my entire way down there so I can show that I don't commit the same stupid mistakes, you know, 47 times in a row. 46 is pretty common. I usually don't get up to the 50 mark, however. Alright, so the resupply down to the left. Because I'm gonna need to hit that for sure before I go to the Omega Metroid. I have no interest in your nonsense, Adam. And for all I know, the AI core in my ship is completely gone. Maybe that Omega Metroid just, like, grabbed it and threw it right out of the airlock. The ship itself, that is. Oh, but that would suck, because if that ship gets destroyed, then my little buddies on there who taught me how to shine spark and wall jump, they got killed too. That's the opposite of something somehow cool. Alright, I don't know if I... Nope, I can't save. Alright. Holy shit, that means I have to do this whole thing as a single attempt? Killing the sacks, like all three forms of the sacks, and then coming down here and fighting off the Omega Metroid? Damn! This game does not fucking pull punches. There was some hard shit in Metroid Prime too, but I don't know that it approached this. I mean, and unfortunately, the difficult parts of Metroid Prime were because of the shitty control scheme. Which people say is awesome with the motion controls, but yeah. Sorry, can't do that. My wrists do not work that way. Alright, so attempt number two on this. Let's see if I can just try to go back. Yeah, okay, you come right out. Okay, so let's just get hit so I can save time. Go ahead, knock me down. There we are. One health. And the sack should come in. Come now, Saxman. Come now, Saxman. Thank you. I mean, I wonder if you're just choosing... I think I know why you'd be protecting me here. Metroids are your enemies, and I have some Metroid DNA, but this is a much bigger, much scarier Metroid than I am. So you'd want to take that thing out. And the enemy of my enemy is very briefly my friend, weirdly. Alright, let's see if I can do this. Just run in, run out, hit you in the chest. Change of colors, that's good, that's good. Ow, 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 shit fire, that hurts me. You take off one energy tank per swipe, it looks like. So I cannot get hit. You're gonna get a little bit quicker, a little bit more desperate. You know, beams wouldn't hurt you at all on SR388, least of all the ice beams, so I don't know what we're doing here. It's weird, I've been fighting X the entire game, and now my final boss, apparently, is not an X, but a Metroid. Oh yes, Adam, please come in. And also, don't tell me that was the final boss, because that was kind of a little too easy. I guess actually doing all four of those in a single run with the 3-minute counter on the end, that could be a pretty formidable final boss. I could put all of those together and say that was a fairly satisfying final boss. Okay, does that destroy all of SR388? I hope so. Because fuck those guys. God. Alright, how do you feel now, Samus? That perfect military mind, the wisdom of Adam Malkovich, continued to serve even after death. Yeah, so Biologic did do something. They did take Adam's consciousness and imprint it into Silicon. Until today, I had no idea that the minds of leaders and scientists were freak... okay, so we're just hand-waving it away. Uploaded to computers, my incredible reunion... This is kind of... not really Deus Ex, but just like a weird-ass coincidence. How did Biologic know? I mean, I guess there's probably records that would show that Adam was your old CO. Why would they want to reunite you two? Did they think that Adam would be especially adept in commanding you? And why wouldn't they just outright tell you, hey, this is a Silicon imprint of your old CO's consciousness? That would have changed the dynamic between the two of you right from the start, rather than having this weird duplicitousness. But how will the beings of the universe view our resolve? Will they resolve to resolve resolutely? I doubt they will understand what we did, the danger barely averted with... Wait a second, if Adam was on board with getting rid of the X and the Metroids all in one fell swoop, then why did it have the pretense of telling you not to do that at first? Why did you have to cajole it? Maybe Adam himself might not have been thinking clearly at first and just blithely accepted orders until Samus was able to talk him into something smarter, I guess. I don't know. They will hold us responsible. Adam understood this, and he spoke to me in my anger. Do not worry. One of them will understand. One of them must. I've reflected upon his words, and I see the wisdom in them. Okay. We are all bound by our experiences. They are the limits of our consciousness. What the hell are you talking about now, Samus? But in the end, the human soul will ever reach for the truth. That is what Adam taught me. That's unfortunately not true. The human soul reaches for comfort, not for truth. At least not unless you're being honest with yourself. Just one detail still bothers me. This ship can only be started manually. Yet before I faced the Omega Metroid, the ship moved on its own. Guided. Obviously Adam moved it. Well, yeah. Dude, why is that even a question? Of course he did. Lady, what's troubling you? You wonder how I started the ship. Just think about it. They lent me a hand. Oh. The intelligent creatures who taught me how to shine spark and wall jump. You brought them up front and said, press this button, press this button, now press that button, now press that button. Now off we go. You're monster buddies. Aww. They're weirdly adorable when they're not engaged in carnivorous behavior. Actually, I don't know if they eat meat. So all of those put together really were the final boss. That's not terrible. I mean, it certainly... if I had known that they were the final boss, I would have done them all on camera as one big contiguous chunk, but... actually, I could still do that, couldn't I? Maybe I'll just go back and edit it after the fact, and so you see me on the successful attempt doing that. I don't know. It depends on how I, like, split up the saves. I don't know if I can make that work. We'll see. But, okay. So, I realize now that my tendency to do post-game analysis during the credit rolls is actually really redundant, because I basically said everything that needs saying during the game. I probably won't replay this, not because there isn't good stuff. There absolutely is good stuff. There's some awesome stuff in this game. It just frustrates me that I will not have the patience to go A to press through all the text that I already know what everything says. And honestly, the text is really not that great. It just is kind of confusing and raised more questions than answers. And it's not like I felt some, you know, buoying to the heart. It wasn't some great thing like, oh my god, she got reunited with her as CEO in computer form. Whatever. So, gameplay, though linearized and a little bit more railroaded, pretty dang solid. pretty dang solid. I would have liked some different upgrades. Some more stuff like the diffusion missile, but I would be mistaken. Oh, damn it. I'm just going to be sad every time I see his name now. I'm sorry, Iwata. Okay, yeah. I would be mistaken to say that there isn't legitimate stuff to enjoy in this game. There absolutely is. This game had some serious high quality working for it, and I've got to give praise where it's due. Hello, Samus. In your ex-suit? How do you feel about things? Tell me! I'm not going to get to see you naked now, because I took way too long, of course. Clear time! 475,000 hours. 4.5. That's quicker than I did the last game. Your rate for collecting items is the 50. Wow, really? There's that much more, huh? So, would there this be like a still photo of her in a swimsuit? I saw like a piece of fan art at some point that showed like Samus without her suit, like in the Zero suit, but after the Metroid DNA infusion, that showed her with like Metroid fangs, and it kind of made me sad. Because to think that her body had been so irrevocably changed like that, it's kind of a similar sadness complex that might exist next to, say, somebody who loses an arm. You know, this irrevocable, I'm really bad at pronouncing words, this irreversible body change that's going to change that person's life forever, and it made me kind of sad. But, you know something that's an anticlimax? And Adam said that there were 10 sacks on the station, and I only got to fight one. Why tell me there were so many if my climax of the game was only getting to fight one? It wasn't a terrible climax, but I just don't know that you should even have, like, hint dropped, hey, there's 10 sacks here, you're only going to see one, and the rest will die in burning flames when the space station crashes into Zeb's hoobadoo. Alright, there's probably nothing more after this. Yeah, I think my save is just going to reload where I was before. Yep, this is my last save right before the thingy wingy. Okay. So, I guess that's it. It doesn't seem like there's any major massive amount of content that I would have otherwise gotten that's not, you know, just going around collecting items. Oh, and yeah, now that I finished the game, I can see 9 more energy tanks, huh? Man, I would have felt actually kind of too strong if I had that many energy tanks, despite the enemies being able to take me down, you know, either a half of an energy tank or one energy tank per hit. But still, it's fine. This game had its good stuff, and I can leave it at that. I have an idea for what my next LP project will be. I do. And people who follow my LPing work might have noticed a pattern. I played some handheld Zelda games, and then went back to try to beeline and use the complete deconstructionism of nostalgia to see how good of a game Link to the Past really was. So if I follow that pattern after having played a couple of handheld Metroid games, that means there's probably something similar I need to do for my next project. I know it sounds horrible and unfun and boring because of how overdone that game is, but I think I might have a way to do it, inspired by my Link to the Past LP, that would make it interesting. I hope. I have some ideas. We'll see how it goes. Thanks for watching, as always, dudes. This, you know, despite my consistent, not really varied complaints, I didn't find a whole lot new to complain about, but despite that, I did pretty much enjoy this game. I don't think I'll come back to play it again because of the word walls, but I did pretty much enjoy it. This was not the most painful thing I've done. There was some really good shit here. So, all right, yep, thank you for watching, as always. I will see you next mission. My God, I want to slap myself for just speaking that slogan for no goddamn reason. I'll see you next time, guys. Thanks.